Hey guys, it's Naturally Coily G. I'm coming at you with a video on my current favorite hair care products for my natural hair. I'm not sure whether my hair is a combination of 4B and 4C, but I'm going to say it is. Some of my curls are kind of tight, but not really, and then the other ones are like super duper tight, and it shrinks my hair so much to the point where I have to like kind of give it a little like heat, I want to say. Not really heat, because I don't like heat, but I will like let it air dry and kind of stretch it in order to get a preferred style. But I'll make a whole tutorial another day about my hair and the type of texture that it is. So let's just jump right into my favorite hair care products. So the first one that I'm going to be coming to you with is Carol's Daughter's Mimosa's Honey. I really like this. It's a shine pomade hair dress, and it has beeswax control for flyaways. That's like the little strands that you'll have in the back of your hair, like if you want to put it in a ponytail or something, and like it's like the little stragglers in the back. So that's what the flyaways is. And it has nettle extract to soften your hair. Now, this product smells absolutely amazing, and I've had it for a while. I want to say maybe like a year and a half or so, just because I really don't want to run out of it because it's so expensive. Well, it's not so expensive, but it is on the expensive side. But this is how much I have left in here. I like to usually put this on my hair after I wash it. Like when it's either blow dried out, or after I stretch it, or after like a twist out, it like really feels really nice on my hair and it's really soft. So yeah, I definitely do recommend this. It is a little pricey, but it is worth it. You know, you get what you pay for. You can find this on carolsdaughter.com. You can go to Macy's.com or go into the Macy's store nearest you and you can pick it up. And yeah, so Carol's Daughter. The next one that I'll be reviewing for you, well, not necessarily reviewing, but telling you about, is Curl. And this is Passion Fruit Curl Control Paste. Now, I'm not a big fan of gel in my hair all the time, so when I feel like I put too much gel in my hair and I want to give it a break from the gel, I use this, and this is like a jam. This, it smells really nice to me, like in a fruity, pleasant kind of way. It's supposed to be passion fruit, so I can imagine like if this is what passion fruit smells like it's okay. I'm not crazy about it, but it's not horrible. It's kind of sweet. But I've used this, I go through this quite often, so usually like when I go into Sally's or if I go into like Target or Walmart and they have this, I usually pick up like 3 or 4 at a time. This is, I believe I pay like $7 for this, maybe 8, and I pick up like 3 at a time, so I'm paying like what, $24. For this stuff. A little pricey, not so much, but I love it. And like it slicks the roots up like so well. It does have kind of a waxy texture to it. Like it's like jam. I don't know if you've used jam before, but if those of you who've used jam, it's kind of like that without the extreme cakiness and leftover residue. But yeah, no, I love this stuff. I'll definitely continue to get it. It's a staple in my collection. The next one that I'll be coming to you with are two, actually. They're the Shea Moisture products. Absolutely, absolutely, absolutely love Shea Moisture products. Like, I'm a Shea Moisture junkie. I don't care if I have 3 of these, like when they go on sale, because I generally get them from Walgreens, I get them when they're on sale for like buy one, get one half off, or buy one, get one free. I'm not sure if there was buy one, get one free before, but there's definitely buy one, get one half off. And I always stock up on this. Like, Shea Moisture is such a staple in my collection. Like, it's not even funny. I live for Shea Moisture. This one is the Coconut and Hibiscus Curling Gel Soufflé with agave nectar and flaxseed oil. This is for thick and curly hair. I didn't open this one, so I'm not going to yet because I still have one that I have that is opened and I'm like almost finished with it. So it smells so heavenly. I love it. Like, it's empty, so you can see that. I'm not lying when I say I really use this stuff. And I already have my backup. But this, like, it gives my hair, like, a hold that a gel would without feeling extremely heavy on my hair. I like to put this on my hair generally when it's wet. I love doing my twist outs using this stuff. My hair is in a scarf right now because, like, I have, like, tried to, like, flat twist the front. So that I have like a decent style to wear to church tomorrow. So I'll let you know how that came out. It's like nothing fancy because I'm like horrible at flat twisting, but yeah. But I use this in the curl enhancing smoothie from Shea Moisture. This also matches the gel soufflé. So this one, it smells the exact same. It's a little thicker in texture. You can see I definitely use this. So, yeah. I wet my hair a little bit, and then I put the curl smoothing enhancing and, like, brush that out. And then once I get ready to, like, flat twist or two-strand twist, I put the gel in. And I found that my curls come out, like, pretty defined when I take it out. So that's that. My next dual products that I'll be telling you about is Alasta Olive Oil and Mango Butter Curl Defining Pudding. And the same product, but the leave-in conditioner. I put this in my hair after I finish washing my hair. And I just like the smell of it. Like, it's mango and olive oil. I use this a lot. And this also I get while it's on sale in Walgreens. They usually are like $5.99, so not really expensive. And the Shea Moisture by itself, I believe I pay like $10.99 for it. So I don't think it's that expensive. It's very affordable. Definitely these are very affordable. I get these when they're on sale. Don't know if I mentioned that already, but yeah. This Holy Grail, I love my Shea Moisture, but I love the Alasta QP's curling pudding just as much, probably second to Shea Moisture. But my curls come out so defined whenever I use this stuff, and it smells so nice. My hair, like when it's finished and even just putting it on, like my hair is really soft. When I take out my twist outs, if I choose to do my twist outs with this, and like, I just love this. Like, this says that it's intensive treatment, so I'm assuming that this is for like if you have like really puffy and kind of coarse hair like mine is, or frizzy hair, like this definitely controls it. So I definitely recommend those. And hey, it's $5.99, so why not? Next. For oiling my scalp, like I do love my hair oils, but you need to be careful with doing that so often. So for my hair grease, I've been using Blue Magic's organic greases, hair and scalp conditioners are what they're called actually. And this little baby right here was $2.99 at your local grocery store. I'm not sure if you can see. See that? There you go. But yeah, $2.99. And this one was also $2.99 from my local beauty supply store. I think I said grocery store. But you could definitely find these in the grocery store, but I think at the grocery store, they're probably like $4, $3, $4. so close to it, if not the same, maybe a little bit more, but hey, it's definitely worth it, and you get 12 ounces worth of grease, so you're definitely getting your money's worth. This one has vitamin E in it, and it's for your hair, obviously, it's hair food. It has wheat germ oil, coconut oil, it prevents hair breakage, and is great for dry, brittle hair. I told you in one of my other videos that my hair was damaged from me going to a hair salon and the beautician burning my hair, so I had to cut my hair off again and start from scratch when I big chopped back in August of 2013. I've just been using this. I've used their coconut hair grease in the past, and I do like it, but I feel like it's a little too oily sometimes, so I'd rather just use natural organic coconut oil for my hair instead of using the grease. So this I've been using for like the past month and a half. Smells very nice. It's a pleasant smell, like very soft. But I've definitely noticed like my scalp taking to it. So it's definitely a hair food grease, as it says. But yeah, like that's been really good. And also, when I want to take a break in between using regular castor oil that I would pick up from Whole Foods, I use the Blue Magic Organic Castor Oil Hair Grease Base. And this has 100% castor oil in it, shea butter, and aloe vera. Now, the hair food one did smell good, but I think this one smells a little bit, if not so much better than the hair oil, because it's like a soothing, pleasant, calming sort of smell. And it does smell a little bit like coconut to me, even though coconut isn't in it. But yeah, like, love this one. I probably stick to this one over the hair food, or maybe not, I don't know. You know, I like them both, so, and they're only $3, so, like, why not? Next is the Beautiful Textures Moisture Butter Whipped Curl Cream, and this is for mixed textures, curly, wavy, kinky, coily, and frizzy. Love this stuff, too. And I ran out of their curling pudding, but their curling pudding, love it. Like the Shea Moisture, the Elasta QP, and the Beautiful Textures Curling Pudding, staples, my top three, love them to pieces. This one smells really nice as well. I haven't really used this one. I got this while it was on sale too at Walgreens. This is $4.99, I believe. $4.99 or $5.99. Super affordable. But this stuff I love. Like I said earlier, I don't know whether or not I have like 4B or 4C hair combination-wise, or if it's just 4B on its own and 4C on its own. But this stuff, I love it. It definitely does the job in the curly, wavy, kinky, coily, frizzy department. My next product that I will use, I usually use this when I would like to straighten my hair. I haven't done this in a while, like since my hair was straightened last May. But like this stuff really does work. This is New Options Natural Hair Care. I got this at my local beauty supply store. This is definitely on the pricey side. This is $24.99, 16-ounce jar. They also have a permanent press, which helps to straighten your hair as well. That is extremely pricey. That one is $50. And you get it in a 16-ounce jar. And it a little goes a long way. You don't need to use a lot whenever you're trying to straighten your hair with this. But how this works is you wash your hair, you detangle it, and then you let it air dry a little bit. After that, you put a little bit of this moisture retainer on your hair, like while it's still damp, and you blow dry that into your hair. Now, when you're blow drying it into your hair, Yeah, it's gonna feel like a little slippery yet gunky at the same time. Like, it's not completely unpleasant, but like it does feel a little weird at first. And after you blow dry it into your hair, you'll notice that your hair will start to straighten out on its own, just naturally from the heat. But this keeps it a little slippery, like the slipperiness that I was talking about. That's the moisture retaining in your hair shaft. After you use the moisture retainer, you would then go on to use the permanent press. And the permanent press serves as, like, if you ever gotten your hair pressed, like, when you were younger, or even now, if you still choose to do so, like, if you use Dex, like, hair grease, like, how thick it is, like, that's what the permanent press is like. And you put that on your hair while it's still slightly damp as well, and you blow dry that into your hair. And you'll be looking like, what is this? Like, you know, I still have a fro. Like, this is a waste of my money. This product isn't real. Like, they lied. But when you go to curl your hair, if you choose to use heat, and you should use heat, that's when you'll get the best results. But when you use the heat and you flat iron your hair or you curl your hair, like, your hair comes out so straight, it looks like a perm. And I remember when I first used it, people were like, oh my God, like, you went back to, like, that creamy crack, like, you permed your hair again. And I was just like, no, like, it's just pressed out. And when I mean pressed out, I'm talking about the new options hair products. This is really good. It's really expensive, but like I said, a little goes a long way. My last favorite product is... my Eco Styler Gel. I love the Eco Styler Gel. This is in argan oil. I also have the one in olive oil. Excuse me for a second. As you can see, my olive oil is like done. So I have my backup, and it was on sale at Sally's for like $3.99, and it's 32 ounces, so definitely a steal. I like this because it gives me the strong and firm hold that I need on certain styles when I'm trying to achieve that look without getting flaky and without being like too caked up in my hair. So it's like I don't have to wash my hair out right away or co-wash it right away, because it's not like how black gel is, or if you get clear gel, if you've ever used that before, I believe it's like Pro Style clear gel. Like, I hate that gel with all of me, but it doesn't get like that, and that's why I absolutely love my Eco Styler Gel. This says that it's maximum hold for all hair types, is made with 100% argan oil, and you know argan oil softens your hair, so another plus. Shine smooth and conditions the hair. No flakes, no tack, anti-itch. Contains UV protection, and it's for men and women. So, definitely a staple. When I run out of this, probably even before I run out of it, I'm going to go back to Sally's and probably purchase another one. And let me just say, I love Sally's. Sometimes, you know, it can get a little pricey because, like, I'll see something and just go crazy in the store. But if you are an avid Sally's customer, I would recommend getting a Sally's card so that you can get all of your purchases whenever you go at the at a discounted price for being a Sally's member. So yeah, that's my spiel. These are my favorite products. I definitely recommend them. If you're just trying out new products, you want to see what works for you, definitely give those a go. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't already, please subscribe. And as always, thank you for watching. Bye.